Check it.
Good evening, dear ladies. I would like to bless all of us בעזרת השם שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו אמן שיגיע מבשר אליהו הנביא אליהו תשבי אליהו גלעדי במהרה בנו משיח ודוד אליהו נבזכור לטוב Dear ladies, I would like to remind all of us that this is also for the yahrzeit of רחל בת חננאל חננאל עליה שלום תשמדו בצורה חיים and the yahrzeit of שמחה שמחה בן יעקב עליו שלום תשמדו בצורה חיים ויהרצייט של
ניל אורי בן
אמיל אליהו עליו השלום תשמע זוהר החיים and בעזרת השם all of the נשמות that they have a yahrzeit today had in the morning or tomorrow and they don't have anybody to say עבור them קדיש
אמן
okay that everybody will be זוכה dear ladies today and זה יוצא ממש כמו שצריך we are going to start tzedakah you remember after Rosh Hashanah we had shiurim Racheli told me that she put the shiurim online all of the shiurim she put everything yes so Racheli told me that she put all of the shiurim and you remember that all of the shiurim after Rosh Hashanah is how should we prepare ourselves for next Rosh Hashanah that we will be written in the book of life le'altar immediately
Amen.
So we are going subject by subject. Now we're going to speak about tzedakah, charity, and then we're going to speak about suffering, and from there we're going to go to Sherit Nachalato, the fourth attribute of Hashem, B'siyata Dishmea from Tomer Dvorah, Be'ezrat Hashem. But everything that we do is connected to Tomer Dvorah. If you read the whole book, you'll see that we are going back and forth inside the book. But Be'ezrat Hashem, eventually Hashem will give me the zchut to gather everything and you will see that we studied everything in the book. Amen. So dear ladies, this Shavua is Parashat Vayishlach. And you remember that Yaakov Avinu runs away with his wives and his children and all of his herd. And he goes away from Lavan. And after 3 days, Lavan knows that he went away and he runs after him. And now after they made a treaty among them, he is going to go to Eretz Knan. And Esav is coming with 400 troops to meet him. So dear ladies, please go to rabbinitirz.com or toranitam.com or the YouTube. Hashem gave me zchut to give shiurim about Parashat Vayishlach. But we're going to touch Parashat Vayishlach because it's connected to our subject. Wow. So look how beautiful, and you'll see how beautiful and you... What can I say? The Torah is beautiful. It's astonishing. And the more you study, the more you know that the knowledge that you have, it's only a tip of an iceberg. So, dear ladies, I would like to remind you, Tzion b'mishpat tipadeh v'shaveh b'tzedakah, that Hashem is going to save the children of Israel because of tzedakah. The next Bli Neder, the next lesson about tzedakah, I'm going to touch all of this. I'm not going to do that now because the whole subject is Rabbi Meir Balanes. Why do we have a zchut? Oh, I forgot to tell you, if some can... okay. Why do we have a zchut to give charity tzedakah? כן, את כבר עושה את זה. To give charity tzedakah in these times that we are in exile. So, and all of this is because of Rabbi Meir Balanes. So we see Yaakov Avinu that knows that Esav is coming towards him with 400 troops. And it's written in Parashat Vayishlach, Vayira Yaakov meod vayatzer lo. That Yaakov is afraid. And vayatzer lo, that it makes him suffer because of this. And what does Rashi say about this? Rashi says, Vayar, Shem Ayareg, that he was afraid that he will die. He will be killed, or that his children will be killed. Vayetzer lo, im yarog hu acherim, that if he is going to kill others. We are going, v'siyata dishmaya, to make it parallel to Moshe Rabbeinu. Look at Moshe Rabbeinu, Parashat Shmot. Moshe Rabbeinu sees that there's an Egyptian that hits a Jewish person. Datan ba'aviram, that the Egyptian, this cup, went to his house, Shel Datan, and he slept with his wife, Shulamit Badivri, and she, Meshevet Dan, and she didn't even know that it was him. It was in the morning. He sent him to work. He went in because she was so beautiful. He was with her. He came back, Datan, because he saw that nobody is there working. He came back. And he sees him go out. And because the Egyptians saw that he knows what he did, And they are not allowed, they weren't allowed to touch married women, the Jewish women. So he started hitting him in order to kill him. Comes Moshe Rabbeinu, and it's written like this, Vayefen ko v'cho v'yar k'enish. And it says that he looks all over, to all sides, and he sees that there's no man. Rashi says about this, Vayar k'en ish, she'en ish atzid latzet mimenu she'itgayer. That he saw that in all of the generations until the end of days, from this Egyptian, there's not going to be even one soul that is going to convert to Judaism. So he killed him with the name of Hashem. Tasimu lev. We are going now to Masechet Gittin, to the Gemara, page 56. Over there it says, Neron Kesar, Arak ve'azal ve'eger, ve'nafak mine Rabbi Meir. If you remember the ruining of the first temple, it says over there that Neron Kesar, he came in order to fight with the children of Israel, and he was a big soldier, a big general, and everything that he did, he succeeded in war. He knew how to fight. So he came to Jerusalem, he came to Bal Yerushalayim, and he wanted to know a sign from heaven if he's going to conquer Yerushalayim. So he took arrows from all corners of Yerushalayim, from the walls, around the walls of Yerushalayim, and he started to throw the arrows. Everywhere that he threw the arrows, if it was north, south, east, west, the arrows went into Yerushalayim, into Jerusalem. He understood that Hashem is going to give him to conquer Yerushalayim. But then he said, but this is very weird because no army conquered Yerushalayim and he's going to give me Hashem to conquer Yerushalayim and Beit HaMikdash. So he saw children coming out of a cheder that were studying, small children studying Torah. So he asked them, tell me, what did you study now in the cheder? And they told him, Venatati et nikmati be'edom b'yadam Israel. And I will revenge Edom, the children of Esav, and I will let my children, Israel, the children of Israel, to revenge that they went and conquered Yerushalayim. So Neron, which was a big general, he was thinking to himself, God is giving me the permission to conquer Yerushalayim, but then he's going to revenge and he's going to punish, he says, he's going to punish him. So he said, he was thinking and thinking, and it says in Masechet Gittin, he decided, Barak, he ran away from there. Nobody knew where he went. Meanwhile, he went to the Jewish people, and he converted, and he became Jewish. One of his descendants is Rabbi Meir Balanes. Wow. That's his descendant, Rabbi Meir Balanes. Okay, let's continue. We go to the Gemara, Horiot Yud Gimel, page 13. And it's written over there, Askei l'Rabbi Meir Acherim, which means Rabbi Meir Balanes was called Acherim. Maza Acherim, when you see in the Gemara it's written, Acherim Omrim, they mean Rabbi Meir Balanes, before they called him Rabbi Meir. Because you remember his name was Rabbi Nehorai. I gave lessons B'Siyata Dishmavu. It was Nehorai, and then they changed his name Meir because he lightened, his soul was with such light that he lightened all of the children of Israel with Halacha and Torah. So but they called in the Gemara, when you say Acherim Omrim, you know it's Rabbi Meir Balanes. Let's go back to Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu is afraid, and Rashi says he's afraid because he was afraid that he will kill Acherim. What was he afraid? Not that he will kill other people. He didn't want to kill anybody, but he was afraid that he will kill Rabbi Meir Balanes, that is called Acherim. Look how Rashi was so wise to write it in a note, in a small note. I just told you, it says in Masechet Oriot that Rabbi Meir Balanes is called in the Gemara in several places, Omrim Acherim, he's called Acherim, others. And Rashi says that Yaakov Avin was afraid to kill Esav because he was afraid that he will kill Acherim, which is Rabbi Meir Balanes. You remember who was afraid to kill somebody? It was David HaMelech. King David, you remember he was running away from Shaul, Veshim'i ben Gera was cursing him. and he didn't kill him, and the general says to him, who is this dog that speaks to you like this? You're a king, let me kill him. And he says, no, don't kill him. Hashem told him to curse me. And then what happens? Besefer Melachim, in the book of Kings, David HaMelech Shochev, he's on Eres Dvai, he's going to pass away, and he tells Shlomo HaMelech, his son, that is a king now, and he tells him, don't forget what Shimi ben Gera did to me. Wait, you'll know when to kill him. Why did David HaMelech didn't kill him? Because he knew that from Shimi ben Gera, Mordechai Yehudi tzarech latzet. Mordechai is supposed to come from him. But he didn't have the child that from him Mordechai is supposed to come. Didn't have it yet. So he told Shlomo HaMelech, wait. And you will know when the right time will come, because his tikkun, his fixing is to be killed by sword, by the king, because he cursed the king. But he didn't want him to touch him until the right son will come from that his descendants, Mordechai Yuditze, that we have the Ness of Purim. So here's the same thing. Yaakov Avinu is afraid to kill Acherim. Okay, let's go. Why is he afraid? So let's go back, and I gave you a whole shiur b'siyata d'shmaya about the months. You remember, Yaakov Avinu and Esav, in the womb of their mother, they're fighting, and they're fighting who will have this world and the next world, and then they are fighting also over the months. Who will have the months? Tov, Yaakov Avinu takes Yaakov. He takes the month of Nisan, Iyar, v'Sivan, 3 months. Nisan is Exodus, saving the children of Israel from Egypt. Nachon? Yetziat Mitzrayim. Iyar is the preparation for receiving the Torah, Sfirat HaOmer, preparing to receive the Torah. And Sivan is Ma'amad Har Sinai, receiving the Torah. So what did Esav do? Esav, you'll see when everything is connected, you'll see how beautiful the Torah is. So Esav, b'siyata d'shmaya, he wanted the months. He says, okay, you took Nisan, Iyar, and Sivan. I will take Tammuz, Av, ve'elul. I will take the month of Tammuz. And you remember the 17th of Tammuz, Yudzayin b'Tammuz. They broke all of the walls around Yerushalayim, around Jerusalem. Tisha b'Av, they already burned the temple. Zetisha be'av, and he wanted to take the month of Elul so the children of Israel won't do tshuva. He didn't want them to do tshuva. They won't have, because they will come to Tishrei, which is the Yom Hadin HaGadol, the day that the first human being was created, and he sinned and he repent. So he wanted to take the month of Elul so the children of Israel can't do tshuva, and Chas v'Shalom, Hashem has to judge them, a true judgment. So, dear ladies, Yaakov Avinu fought with him and didn't give him the month of Elul. And instead of this, he took the month of Tevet. And you remember the siege started on the 10th of Tevet. 10th of Tevet, a siege over the walls of Yerushalayim. All of these months, you see only Chorban, only ruining under Esav. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Yaakov Avinu, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Elul belongs, we have our whole lesson only on this, only on the Chodashim, if you remember. It's more than an hour lesson. Please go back and see rabbinitirz.com or toranitan.com or the YouTube. We have a whole lesson only about the Chodashim. And Hashem took Elul and the month of Tishrei, and you see the Aleph Ataf, in order that we can fix ourselves from Aleph Ataf. That's why the first letter of the Hebrew Aleph Bet until the last letter of the Hebrew Aleph Bet. And that's why Beslichot, when we do Slichot and ask forgiveness from Hashem, you see the Slichot starts from Aleph to Bet until Taf, and then from Taf to Aleph, from the last letter to the first letter, and then from the middle, from Mem to Taf, and from, you see it from all over, in order to fix all of the letters that we damaged in the Torah because of our deeds, of what we did, dear ladies. So now we see that Esav didn't want the children of Israel. He wanted to prevent from them to repent and to do tshuva. Okay. Why? Because it says in Masechet Brachot, page 34, Makom shebaalei tshuva omdim, tzadikim gmurim enam omdim. a place where people who repent stand, even the ones that are righteous cannot stand over there. זה מקום שבעלי תשובה עומדים, צדיקים גמורים אינם עומדים. Why does Esav care about it? Because his angel is the Samech Mem. His angel is the evil inclination. The angel of Esav is the evil inclination. And the evil inclination knows, that b'siyata d'shmaya, if a person repents and not continues to sin, then his degree, his level is higher than the level of even righteous people. And because of that, the evil inclination loses even the job that he did in order to cause a person to sin. אתם רוצים לעצור רגע? So let's... אבל אף אחד לא מקשיב. תעצרי רגע.